We talk about open world games all the time, but sometimes there's more to it than just a big map where you can go anywhere as far as the eye can see. No, today we're talking bigger, and we're looking at 5 game worlds that are technically bigger than planet Earth. Now bear with us, this is a broad one, and there is some random procedural generation, and there's a lot of math involved, even though we're really bad at it, but this is a fun topic, so buckle up and let's get started off with number 5. Let's talk about Minecraft. This one is definitely something most people can grasp. Minecraft is big. It's really, really big. Play the game for like, you know, an hour or so, and you'll quickly start to get a sense of just how vast it is. Land seemingly endlessly sprawls in multiple directions. There's always another mountain to discover and scale, a body of water to challenge, a forest to go punch trees in. Minecraft grows in size as you explore it. But contrary to popular belief, Minecraft does not go on forever. Apparently, each block is 1 square meter, and Minecraft's world maxes out at 600 million square kilometers. Now, according to Dimitris Galatas VFX on YouTube, Minecraft has 7.05 times the area of the Earth, and it's straight up as big as planet Neptune. Minecraft does a really good job of making it feel like it's endless. You know, the sprawling landscapes that I mentioned and the hidden underground caves do seem to go on forever, but really it's that lonely mood and atmosphere to it all, especially in the early days of the game, that really helped make it feel so freaking massive. Now, this game is worth highlighting not only for that, but also because of one man's quest to explore all of it, to reach the furthest depths and distances. Kurt J. Mack is highlighted by Guinness World Records for the longest journey in Minecraft from a starting spawn point. This was recorded on March 6th, 2018, and he traveled a total of 3,280.57 kilometers. Now, this of course isn't everything. You know, Minecraft's vastness is in the square blocks of it all, from the skies to deep underground, but still, we thought that was really worth highlighting and incredibly impressive. Kurt has been capturing his journeys and, since 2011, has raised $500,000 for charity, which is really kick-ass, and we wanted to mention that. But moving on over to number 4, No Man's Sky. No Man's Sky isn't open world, but I guess more of open universe? Like, the universe will continually procedurally generate as you travel through it. Each planet, though, is huge. Like, each planet is different, they have their own weather, biomes, plant, and wildlife, and they're all drastically different from feeling. You can find weird planets that seem to be made of metal, ones that are more moon-like, ones covered in water with a few islands scattered about, Earth-like planets, or ones that seem like a paradise, but it's purple. You know, it's kind of endless, honestly. Yeah, with the Beyond update, they made it so you can play with other players, but No Man's Sky still has a real lonely vibe to it, which makes the game seem that much bigger. Because a lot of these planets are pretty empty. They're still very fun to explore, but they are really just straight up mostly empty. You mostly just come across abandoned outposts or crashed freighters. Now, the sound design and music also really adds to the loneliness as well. I can't quite explain why, but it does. It's almost like Hello Games put thought into every single little detail to make sure the game constantly feels huge and open, and to also make it feel like you're just a small dot in this big, crazy universe. And really, it's the planet size that helps make you feel that way. Coming up to a planet and it grows in size is really just an incredible feeling that's just made through numbers and code. The game is so big that there are players that have dumped hours into this game and still haven't been able to find a planet to settle down and call home. Everyone is searching and everyone wants that perfect planet with little to no sentinel activity, no harsh weather, and of course it has to look cool. Some are lucky enough to find it early on, but some players are just still jumping from galaxy to galaxy, planet to planet, looking for that perfect planet to settle down and make their base. That's some real sci-fi stuff if I've ever heard any, but thankfully that search is all just a big part of the game, and it's all so much fun. But next at number 3, Star Citizen. Yep, yeah, we're gonna talk about it. This spaceship game is shaping up to be absolutely massive, although it's not out yet. Some folks think it's never gonna come out, maybe because it's too ambitious. And now, this thing was first kickstarted in 2012, and it raised just over $2 million, but Eurogamer has pointed out that that has grown to about $250 million, thanks to an influx of new supporters over the years, and backers and stuff. Also, I mean, the fact that they're selling in-game spaceships you can buy with real-world money, and some of those can be really pricey, that definitely helps. But really, people believed in the concept of a science fiction game with high quality, realistic graphics where you can go anywhere and do anything. Now, this is a divisive game, and we're not going to get into all that, but some fans are absolutely in love and can give this game all of their faith, while others are much more skeptical and think that the game keeps making promises it's never going to totally deliver. But we have seen some great stuff come out of it so far. Not going to lie. We're just here to kind of get a sense of how big it can all be. Well, a few years ago, the team making Star Citizen said their goal is to have a galaxy with a volume of 400 quadrillion cubic kilometers. Now, a demo in 2017 demonstrated the size of the game, with the developers expressing the fact that on the surface, the sky isn't just a skybox, a rendered image of a sky. No, it's actually all places you can go. We got to see the player hop in a ship and warp 23 million miles to get somewhere else in the game. So, not only is the size impressive, but the speed of traveling through it is as well. But the most recent word, according to Digital Foundry taking a look at the Star Citizen 3.8 Alpha, the developers converted the game's engine to use 64-bit coordinates to allow the game to have solar system-sized game spaces. 536,870,912 times larger than a space built on 32-bit float coordinates. Now, without getting too into the game developer weeds, at least not more than we already have, there's a lot of manual construction here with a mix of procedural elements. And we don't have an exact number or crazy math on how big it all is now, but with how it's shaping up and with what the developers have shared and what some people have been able to experience, we deemed Star Citizen to be worthy of landing on this list because it sounds very big so far. But down to number two, Elite Dangerous. This is a big game, and we mean big. How big, you say? Well, the Galaxy of Elite Dangerous is a one-to-one scale simulation of the Milky Way galaxy, and not just in like a totally generic way, but based in a system built on real scientific principles, theory, and data. The whole galaxy is actually modeled on current galactic charts and includes around 400 billion star systems and 42 galactic regions, with planets and moons existing in a realistic fashion and following proper orbital rules, rotating and orbiting in real time and constantly changing the environment of the systems. The interesting thing about Elite Dangerous's galaxies is that it's created using a combination of both procedural generation while also having curated and artist-made systems, meaning that, you know, systems like Alpha Centauri and Sol are properly represented in the galaxy for you to travel and check out. But then there are also a ton of procedurally generated star systems that can contain any manner of things, from cosmic phenomena like black holes, comets, pulsars, and a bunch of other weird stuff that you can kind of just stumble across in your space exploration. And with a game world of that scale, you really do just stumble across the weird stuff. It happens more often than you think, and sometimes the stuff is so out there that it makes the headlines. Like, take this guy, Robert D.P. Sayer Bedig, for example. In 2017, he was just doing his usual thing out there in the galaxy, running trade routes, exploring, you know, Elite Dangerous stuff, until he was cruising through hyperspace and got yanked out of it by an unknown source. And all of his systems went dead. And before he knew what was up, creepy music kicks in and an incredibly unsettling, organic-looking alien spaceship just started passing by overhead. It scanned his ship and then just bounced off. It was a pretty incredible moment for everyone. And we're really just happy he was able to capture the whole thing on video. I mean, look at this. It's just wild. But it's not just that kind of random chance encounter that makes the galaxy so cool, but like things the community does with each other. That's really the emphasis in this video. Take this story, for example, like where this one player, known as Commander Diluvian, he was trying to break records with an expedition to get to the furthest point from the galaxy's sun, but ended up getting stranded when he ran out of fuel. He traveled 141 light years away from the part of the galaxy where players tend to congregate and hang out, so he really did get super far out there, and he was really, really stuck out there, floating around for 3 months. This is when a group of players known as the Fuel Rats, whose whole MO is rescuing players who are stranded and require emergency fueling, got involved. The Fuel Rats mounted a 600-hour rescue mission to bring Diluvian home, and they pulled it off too. Although Diluvian unfortunately didn't break the record he was attempting to, but hey, at least he got a cool story out of it, right? Stuff like this would only be possible in a game world as vast as this one, and we really do love to see it. But now to number one, you know where we're gonna mention it, EVE Online, because wow, this is not only a big game world, but it's just massive in terms of how people engage with it. And even still, despite that, so many people barely have any idea what it is. EVE Online is a space game, yes, but it's a vast collection of systems where players can explore and mill about, commune together, and wage epic battles in what is pretty much an online subscription-based multiplayer game like no other, especially because of the corporate structure and the in-game economy and trading. EVE Online has its own complex economy with trading and commerce and a political system, too. All of this evolves around the player base and what they do. There is in-game currency and real-world currency, and people spend a lot of real-world money on this game. Now, we've covered many stories of massive, ongoing space battles in EVE that cost hundreds of thousands of real-world dollars. That's all well and good if players like that, good for them, but the world of EVE itself is bigger than Earth, obviously, not just because it's a space game, but because of how it's structured. New Eden is vast, and it's filled with known star systems of about 5,000 and a bunch of unknown, too. There are about 8,000 systems that you can visit in this game. Now, shout out to Steam user Shotgun, who broke this down a few years ago. First of all, I just want to point out, too, many people actually break down stuff in AU, or astronomical units, the real-world system of measurement to represent a unit of length, roughly the distance from Earth to the Sun, and equal to about 150 million kilometers. Well, according to Shotgun, the average radius of a system in EVE is roughly 17 astronomical units. That is very large, man, obviously. Even more impressive, the furthest an object can spawn is 4 AU from any other static object. So anyway, with all of Shotgun's calculations, because honestly we're not very good at math, EVE Online's play spaces total up to roughly 249 sextillion square kilometers. And that's just rough math, according to him. Now, I've probably butchered this, and EVE fans will probably be mad at us, but the reality is, we're just in awe and completely amazed by the design of this game, consistently. You look at a map, and every dot is a new system to explore, and that's overwhelming right there, even without all of the math. Now, we also want to highlight an EVE player who goes by their in-game character name, Katia Sei, who spent 10 years exploring all of the corners of those 8,000 star systems. Katia didn't touch every single planet, but through doing calculations, warping through space, and taking advantage of in-game wormholes, they have seen probably way more than most players. And we still don't have time to get into all of the weeds of the details on how they do it, but the bottom line is, EVE is insane. And even if you only vaguely appreciate video game world sizes, maybe you don't even care about space games, just thinking about and breaking down EVE Online can really blow your mind. But those are some big old game worlds. These game worlds are bigger than planet Earth. There are more out there. There are more examples that are less space gamey, but we found those to be the most fascinating. We want to hear from you guys down in the comments. What are some of your favorite massive game worlds? Let's talk about anything about big game worlds and just space game adventures down in the comments. If you learned something, maybe you enjoyed this video, clicking the like button is the best way you can help us out. We'd really appreciate that. And if you're new, it's worth considering subscribing and hitting that notification bell because we put out new videos every single day. But hey, as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.